in your respective capacities. I must say that I'm totally blown away. I have been part of the school for many years, and I thought I knew a lot of things about the school, but I hadn't seen them in a very organized way, such as what we have seen today. And it really demonstrates excellent leadership from Professor Basilio, but also excellent teamwork from the rest of us. And I like the innovation of recognizing everybody up to the lowest level. And for that, I think we need to give another big round of applause to them. I first met Professor Basilio many years ago, and I don't want to say how many, otherwise you might be counting the gray hairs on my head as well, but sometimes he likes to remind me, and I don't know about his memory, but he remembers how I was dressed many years ago when I found him. Please don't say. But so every time that I met him, right from that time, he always talks about a few things, but one has really stuck, always leave a trail. And you can see from what he has shared that he has indeed left a very big trail, and we need to thank him for that. But I would also like to thank Professor Wabire and Professor Serata, because they set a very good foundation. Sometimes we forget past leaders, and because of that, sometimes people don't want to be past. But I would like us not to forget these two gentlemen, because they have done a lot for us. They have been our teachers, our mentors, and they have done a lot of things to grow our school to the level where Professor Basilio found it, and all the great things that he has shared with us today. Please join me to thank Professor Wire and Professor I have had the opportunity to talk with the three gentlemen one-on-one, and I have tried to sometimes blackmail them a little bit to make sure that they keep with us for a long time. But I would like to say one of the things that I have said to all of them in different ways, that with all the success we have just seen today, and that big trail, I personally believe that the greatest success for the three men and for Professor Basilio, as you see, is going to lie in how well you support us to successfully succeed you. This is not your finishing line, and I know sometimes they have told me, maybe we won't be here with you. That's okay, you can go wherever you want to, but we hope you can be our good ambassadors. The world is very small now. Even when you go away, we can reach you in a few seconds. So I hope you can still do that. And I must say to all of you that all indications are that they are going to succeed in doing that as well. So we need to thank you. I would like to say on my own behalf that I'm excited. At the same time, when you hear what they say, I sometimes think, oh, well, what am I getting into? Because when you hear Professor Basilio, then you think, oh, you will have no life, starting from when he passes on the baton. But I think I'm privileged to walk in your footsteps. And I think that I represent what you have all done to mentor me. So I am optimistic that I'm going to make it. And I think I could do better. I have... And sometimes you ask me, how will you fit in those shoes? They are so big. And I just didn't realize how big they are till Professor Basilio started drawing his slides. And I don't know if this will disappoint you or surprise you, but I have no intention of stepping in those shoes. I am coming with my own pair. It's a little shorter,
and higher.
And it's higher off the ground most of the time, and I hope that represents where we are heading.
Right.
And sometimes it has the notorious habit of announcing my presence before I arrive. And some people say, I know Ron is coming. So I hope all that is a telltale sign of where we are headed. And I'm very confident that with your support, we will actually get there. We have very big dreams as a school and as individuals. And with friends like you, we surely must make it. Hanson is here, the principal is here, the deans are here, the director of quality assurance is here. And with all of you, and I mean all of you in the School of Public Health, because you all make a very great contribution to what we are today, and we are looking to all of you in terms of where we are heading tomorrow. I believe we shall get there. There's one thing I would like to say before I stop, because I'm not walking in Dr. Bavelian's shoes, so I'm going to be very brief. When you hear all that he has shared with us, you see a lot of success. And sometimes when we are looking at success, that is all we want to see. We don't want to look back and we don't want to look ahead, because he wants the uncertainties of the future. He gives us a head, right? But you can see that he has tried to do that. He's given us the entire history, a great job. He has also looked ahead and he has even made commitments on my behalf without talking to me. So I have a challenge, but I will talk with him more. He still has several weeks to make some executive orders, so maybe he's not clear at least before he leaves. But what I really want to say, that sometimes we forget to reflect. And the reflection that I would like us to make as we look forward is, where are we in terms of growth and development? When you look at the cycle of organizational development, and I know that this is not new to many of us, because we are teaching leadership, but there is that cycle and things that happen to an organization, and when you don't reflect carefully, you can actually go down before you know it. And I was thinking before I came here, and also as he was growing on, and wondering, are we a child that is still exploring, unsure of the circumstances around them and holding on to their mother all the time? Might we be an overconfident and stubborn adolescent that's threatening to burst at the seams? Or are we a mature adult that has the right level of confidence but humility as well, to be able to celebrate our success, but also laugh at our failures, pick up the pieces and move forward? Or might we be at our peak potential? My view is that these questions and a few others are going to be very critical as we chart the way forward for the school. And this is not the subject for today. Professor Bazelia said that I was going to start writing my notes for the end of 4 years as he talks, but I'm looking to an opportunity where I can share with you all, and I hope you will come, including our very good friends from council and everywhere, to hear where we are headed, instead of waiting for 4 years, because it helps for you to be part of writing the future, rather than wait to see when it has happened. But I'm going to share with you my own views and analysis, index based on this cycle and more. And I'm also going to consult with you about all, because I know all of you have your own analysis and your own views of where we should begin. And I look forward to that opportunity in the near future, because it's going to be really crucial for us to make sure that we can achieve renewal as well as sustainability. But that's not really the subject for today. Today is really to thank Professor Bazelia on behalf of all of you and on my own behalf. Also to thank all of you for being here, our friends from council, our principal, the deans, and the director of quality assurance. Thank you very much for coming.